Hey, what's up, guys? John here. I cannot believe the insanity that we're all stepping into as real estate investors, property owners. We're looking around and we're saying, hey, property prices are sky high. Unemployment, we have 10 million plus people out of work. Yet prices keep going up, up, up. We're printing a ton of money. And the argument behind that is the values of properties are going to be what's really going to matter. This toilet paper money is not going to mean anything. But then you look at this crazy legislation, the bills they're trying to pass right now, where they can basically take your property. Seriously, you know, I wouldn't say that this would be possible a year ago, 2 years ago. But unfortunately, it seems like every request from above, everyone just obeys it and they just comply because they don't want to make a fuss. That cancel culture movement was the smartest thing for them simply because it just kept everybody quiet. They don't want to get canceled. They don't want to get shamed publicly. So they just agree. They look to the left, look to the right. Everyone's just complying. So like, okay, I'm not going to make a big thing about it. Well, now people are going to lose their properties. What's insane to me is this eviction moratorium is mandated by Big Brother. And if you don't follow, then you'll get in trouble. If you do follow, then they're gonna try to steal your property. I'm gonna go through this entire article here because it is important. Everybody that's gonna be investing right now or next year, the following year, should be paying attention to what's happening this very moment because this is gonna lay the groundwork for everything to come. So please smash that like button. It does so much for this video, but most importantly, it educates everybody else. YouTube sees that they push the video out to more people. The more people that see it and become aware of it, hopefully the more people that can stand up. But seriously, if this continues to get rolled out, imagine what the world's gonna be like in 2 years, in 5 years, in 10 years. We can't be sheep and just obey every single thing because if we do, we're gonna be pushed into a disgusting corner we'll never be able to get out of. So please smash that like button. Let's begin. Ilhan Omar reintroduces legislation to cancel rent mortgage payments during the pandemic. Rep. Ilhan Omar reintroduces legislation that would cancel and forgive rent nationwide and mortgage payments throughout the pandemic. As it stands now, many outstanding payments during the pandemic are in forbearance, which are fully owed payments due in the future. Under Omar's plan, such forbearance would be totally forgiven with no negative impact on credit rating or rental history. That part sounds good. Let's go down. Additionally, the legislation establishes a landlord relief fund overseen by the Department of Housing and Urban Development to reimburse landlords for the loss of rent payments. According to the press release, Omar also wishes to create an optional buyout fund to fully finance the purchase of rental properties by nonprofits, public housing authorities, cooperatives, community land trusts, and state and local governments in order to increase the availability of affordable housing during the downturn. While the American Rescue Plan extends the national rent moratorium, this is not a long-term solution. People across the country will be forced to pay tens of thousands of dollars in back rent when it ends, Omar said. No one should be forced to choose between putting food on the table and keeping a roof over their heads, Rep. Mondaire Jones, a co-sponsor of the bill. Rep. Ayanya Presley, also a co-sponsor, remarked, with the economic impact of the pandemic worsening and the threat of the eviction and homelessness looming large for families nationwide, we must take every measure possible to keep families safely, they love that word, safe, housed, forgive all rental debt, and ensure that the credit scores of hard-hit families are not forever tarnished. The total price of forgiving the loans and rental payments is not known, but would likely be enormous. It's also unknown how the legislation would determine the beginning or the end of the pandemic, which could stretch for months on end. The announcement of the legislation also did not address how the mortgage-backed securities market may be impacted by a federal program that affects debt obligations. Additionally, no market studies were paired with the ramifications of subsidized housing with the legislation's announcement. So how are they going to fund this optional buyout fund? Likely with our tax dollars, with increased taxes under Biden. We're going to be stepping into a period where now they have this eviction moratorium. They issued it one time, they extended it again, and likely they're gonna continue extending it and bleeding this out. We have over 40 million people if they lifted the eviction moratorium today, that would be on the street. 40 million people, that's a conservative number. Every single day we have more and more and more people, and we have the first of the month coming just in a couple weeks. And guess who America's biggest landlord is, who's taken control of the most property in America during the pandemic? Well, it's the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. Operating under the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, has asserted jurisdiction over private residential leases nationwide. It intends to curtail evictions until at least the end of the year. This article was early September. As we all know, everything keeps getting pushed out. And in fact, its new direction threatens federal criminal penalties against landlords who ignore tenant declarations made using the CDC forms. It's unclear, to put it mildly, exactly how this jurisdiction over private contracts and state local courts flows even to Congress, much less an administrative agency acting on its own. One federal official justifies the bizarre and legally dubious action based on the CDC's broad charter to stop the spread of communicable diseases, a charter at which they failed miserably. The fallout from suspending rental contracts will be deep and long-lasting. Many landlords will find their situations untenable and stop making mortgage and property tax payments. New rental housing stock will be depressed as owners worry about the next suspension of rent payments now that the precedent has been set. After all, why would moratoriums happen again when the next pandemic or financial crisis hits? Rental housing units will drop in price as more landlords abandon the business, setting the stage for commercial and private equity buyers to grab units on the cheap from individual and small owners. Ultimately, foreclosures, evictions, and tax sales will happen no matter what the federal government does. The likely outcome is bigger players owning more and more of the rental housing stock, consolidating the permanent renter class, and adding to the rootlessness many Americans feel. Even the most modest home ownership creates skin in the game and encourages better neighborhoods, while areas dominated by rentals lack the same incentives for improvement. And the new owners of rental units will pass all the uncertainty, risk, and potential losses onto millions of Americans in the form of higher rents. Even during the most turbulent periods in American history, including the Great Depression, World War II, and the 1880s tuberculosis outbreak, which killed 1 in 7 people, virtually no one expected the federal government to suspend rent. This, to me, is absolutely insane. I don't know what to think of this. You know, me as a real estate investor, I want to invest in property. Right now, lumber costs went up 180% since the beginning of the pandemic. So you think about that. It's a fifth of overall construction cost. They're skyrocketing, yet wages are falling. People don't have to pay rent. Foreclosures are mounting because they're not being calculated right now, because there are many of them which are in forbearance. You have 1 in 5 renters not paying rent, and these contracts are as good as toilet paper. So what do you do as an investor? Well, for me right now, I was gonna go to New Jersey and buy a bunch of these properties. Now, even with these small properties, I don't even know if it's worth the headache and aggravation, because there's so many things happening right now. This article just came out just a couple days ago with Ilhan Omar passing this legislation or pushing it. It makes me wonder what could happen next month or in 2 months or 3 months. Is it worth going down this road, or should I wait to have all the answers? And right now I'm leaning towards that, waiting to find out what is gonna happen. Joe Biden says that we're gonna be opening up hopefully by the 4th of July. And this is 5 months away. This was supposed to be a 2-week closure, and he's saying now that in 5 months we should be able to open back up. I personally believe we're gonna be stepping into a tsunami of foreclosures, especially now with AI and robotics. All these jobs are gonna be taken out for people's safety, and now people don't have to pay rent. So you look at the direction that we're going. It's going to be survival of the fittest. For investors, the last thing you want to do is put your money on the table and then get completely screwed. So be cautious, be careful, and be very strategic with every single thing that you're doing right now. Learn as much as humanly possible. You know, this is a real estate and personal finance channel, but I want to share everything that I learn, everything that is going to impact us financially. So with that being said, please smash that like button. Help me share this video when you hit the like button, YouTube's gonna share it. So the more people that see it, the better. If you have any friends right now that are investing in real estate, considering to invest in real estate, maybe they flip houses or wholesale real estate, send this to them. I'm really curious as to their thoughts. But most importantly, I wanna help them from making a fatal decision, which could be buying property at the height of the market right now before all this chaos unfolds. So please smash that like button, consider subscribing, and I'll see you guys in the next video.